Now here's a couple of tips about creating tags. When you create thousands of tags, you may have to wait for those thousands of tags to be picked up by the interface that's going to be collecting that data. Let me give you an example. Now here's a tag that uses the OPC interface. That means, or it's being gathered by the OPC interface. Now that means that over here, when this OPC interface starts up, it's looking for all of the tags that have that OPC as its point source. And when it finds tags, it will go ahead and process them, but it'll process them 25 tags at a time. So there's a certain cycle that goes on, a kind of a major cycle of once every 2 minutes we go out to check to see if there are tags. Now, if there's the day that you create 1,000 new tags that all use that OPC point source, again, you're back here on the home node, you create 1,000 tags like this, and then it can take up to 2 minutes for the interface to detect that has happened, and it will go ahead and start processing them, but it'll process them 25 tags at a time. Now at that point, when it sees that there are still more tags to be processed after the first 25, it will go ahead and check again 30 seconds later. So at this point, once it sees there's more to be done, it'll go ahead and process every 30 seconds another 25 tags. Now that does mean that if there are thousands and thousands of tags you just added, it can take a while for all of those tags to be picked up by the interface. So sometimes, if it won't hurt production, what you'll see people do is go over here to the interface node and simply stop and restart the interface. That way we'll go ahead and start scanning all the tags all at once. Now once you've waited for, 2 minutes for your tags to be picked up by the interface, if you still don't see any values, then there's some troubleshooting tips I can suggest. See, here's an example of a tag that I configured, and it's got the right point source, but if I take a look at the section over here, the system tab, you can see that the value here, it does have a value, but I know it's a very old value. It's actually much later than that, than the 18th of February. So I'm looking at a very old piece of data. So there's apparently something going wrong here. Now, and typically when you create a PI tag, and if you don't get a value, you'll simply just see the word point created. Now, if that's the case, then the best place to go to check is to look in the interface log file. So I'll go back to the interface node, and I'll open up the log file. Now I can do that a couple of ways. I can go into the pipc/dat directory and I can look for the file called pipc.log, or I can just go into ICU, Interface Configuration Utility, and this is where you can find that log. If you take a look at the directory here, you can see this is where we normally store that log, pipc/dat. Anyway, what I'm looking for is I'm looking for the point in time when this interface started up, and I'm looking for the number of tags that it found that have that point source. Now, if it didn't find any tags, if the total number of points were zero here, then I would probably go out and look to see if I used the right point source. Because remember, that interface is looking for a couple of matches. It's looking for a matching point source. Let me go ahead and close this. See, it's looking for the tags that have this point source and this interface ID. Now, that interface ID is normally put in location code 1 in the point definition. So let me bounce back to the PI server. And in the PI server, we can see that this tag does match the test. It does have the point source of OPC. And if I look at the classic tag, location 1 is equal to that interface ID number. So on the surface, this looks like it should work. I can't really figure out what the problem is here without going back to that log, though. So let me go back to the interface node. I'll take a look at the log. And it's right here. I'm seeing an error telling me that the event tag, this tag right here, is not found. So, well, that's kind of curious. Let's go back and look at the tag configuration. I'll go back here into general. And normally the event, here's the problem. See this extended descriptor? In an earlier video, I had typed this in here just as an example. If this were an event-driven tag, a tag that's getting its value based on the changes of this tag's value right here. And of course, I left that in there and I accidentally saved it. So what's happening is the interface is starting up. It's finding this instruction, but it can't actually find a tag called this. So that's why it's in error. So I just wanted to use that as an example of where you would find the kind of troubleshooting tools that might help. So you'd go out to the pipc.log on the interface node. Now, since I just saved that, you should see within about 2 minutes, we should see that interface will pick up that I've made that change. And at that point, we should start gathering data properly for this tag. So let me close this. We'll come back and take a look at that in just a second. Now, another troubleshooting tip is if you're still not getting data for whatever reason, and it looks like the interface is configured properly and the point is configured properly, then take a look to see if on the home node there's a trust that exists for this interface. Remember, interfaces are unattended applications, and an unattended application is not typically going to be using Windows Integrated Security. Well, in fact, we suggest that you don't do that. Instead, we suggest that you allow connections to be made, you know, from that connecting interface client to this PI server via trusts. So the thing I would look for is go out to this trust section here and just double check, make sure that there is a trust that exists that, you know, specifies the interface name, etc. Yeah, for more on that, go take a look at the videos on PI trusts and interfaces. Okay, now I just waited 2 minutes, so the interface should have gone out and scanned for that update to that tag. Let's go take a look at the tag, see if it's got a value that's been updated. And I don't see anything here. This is not updated. I'll go ahead and refresh this. Yeah, there we go. I've just refreshed that. It seems to be updating and having good data. So I'm guessing by eliminating this mistake here, the interface has picked up the change and it's gone ahead and started sending data again. Now the real test is, let's go back to the interface node. Let's look at that PyPC.log again. And let's take a look to see if the interface has said anything about this in the log file. Right here I can see that just a couple of seconds ago the interface reported that it added that point pumpspeed.text or test. So it's added that to the collection duties of this interface, and it looks like everything's going okay now.